This matters. What we witnessed in that hearing was nothing short of extraordinary. Put the partisan politics and the insults and the spin to one side. I want to mark this pivotal moment in American history when sexual assault, something that doesn't often elicit more than a shameful whisper, is thrust into the open on national television. Millions tuned in from home, from your mobile device, the subway, even a dad and a daughter in a chemotherapy session. This matters. Yesterday morning, the nation watched as Christine Blasey Ford shared her truth. Look at her. You can see the struggle, the pain. She didn't want to be there, but she said it was her civic duty. She admitted she was terrified. All of this was all on television, and as it played out, I saw women here at work in tears. I had a young woman in my office wiping her eyes as she felt compelled, after listening to the testimony, to share her truth with me. I was texting with a dear friend who had been raped in college and is in therapy years later. For so many, this story has reopened deep, painful wounds. During this hearing, C-SPAN says callers flooded its talk lines to share their own stories of sexual assault.
I'm a 76-year-old woman who was sexually molested in the second grade. This brings back so much pain. I thought I was over it, but it's not. You will never forget it. You get confused and you don't understand it, but you never forget what happened to you.
This matters. Listening to Professor Ford speak about her desire for a second front door to her home, an irrational need for escape many years later. The pain for her and millions of men and women is deeply scarring. This matters. According to the nation's largest anti-sexual violence organization, every 98 seconds, an American is sexually assaulted. One out of every six American women has been the victim of an attempted or completed rape in her lifetime. And incredibly, only six out of every 1,000 rapists will end up in prison. We all have our stories. The spiked drink, waking up on the cold tiles of a hotel bathroom floor, the uncertainty, the shame, the thought I must have somehow brought this on myself, the silence, distrust, and invalidation. This is a pivotal moment in America for all of us. This matters. This moment is bigger than politics. It's about mothers and fathers raising boys to become men. What good comes of all of this? What are we going to learn? It's a generational opportunity to better ourselves in how we relate to each other as women and men. This matters the most.